as a professional, as a journalist that you are, how what is your take on how all these COVID-19 pandemic has affected that is the field that you're in right now?
Well, generally, the COVID-19 has affected all facets of life, not only personal, but also professionally, how we work. And the newsroom is not any different. Perhaps the biggest difference for me so far is the fact that the newsroom is a bit deserted. We have fewer people in the newsroom as opposed to what we used to do, because at the moment we're actually working in shifts. So particularly for the standard media group, we work for 7-day shifts, meaning you work for 7 days and then you rest for 7 days. So in a month, we work for 2 weeks and rest for 2 weeks. These are just part of precautionary measures that the organization has put in place to ensure we are not crowded and we are not all in one place. So at the moment, before even immediately this pandemic began and immediately the shifts kicked in, there of I think a month and a half, and we work together. Yeah? So tunawaonanga tu on air, the way you people also see us on air when our story is running and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So perhaps that's the biggest change. Aside from that, is just basically how we interact now with our news sources. The issue of distance between you and the person you're interviewing has now been a very serious thing that we're always reminded of. Indeed, we do sanitize before we leave the newsroom to go to the field. Mm-hmm. When we come back, we have to sanitize. The equipment have to be sprayed and all that. So it's really different. In fact, right now, just about a week and a half ago, the company introduced some, it's like a microphone holder. It's like a stick. Carry it to like half a meter or a meter long. Mm-hmm. So you put the microphone at the end and then now you point it towards the person you're interviewing as part of the efforts to social distance. So it's for me, it's a bit weird. But we have to do what you have. So it's kind of awkward. Unashikia mtu kijitivi, but everybody understands, including the people who we interview. So perhaps those are the two biggest differences I've seen so far at the moment. Yeah.
You know, it has come to be termed as the new normals. In Najua, you have had to adapt and all that.
Yes. Mm-hmm. It's the new normal. You have to adapt, Mazi.
Mm-hmm. Kabisa sana. So, you see, again, I think, you, of course, on social media, you've had people talking about, you know, skills and everything. Like, this is the time, like, you're trying something new. I mean, right now, even everything has virtually gone online. You know, even this discussion, you're just doing it like, I'm in Nandi, you're in Nairobi, but we're just talking. Mm-hmm. Yeah, is this the way things are working right now?
How is Nandi, by the way?
Nandi is very cold, I can say. But it is very much calm and settled, and just people are just chilling in their kwamanyumba. And if you have a farm, you just can chill by the farm and just take over some animals, maybe.
Understandably so. Same ukupia. Mm-hmm.
Are you getting any skills so far this time you're home? We must see this 2 weeks that you're staying. Are you getting anything? You're trying something new?
I'm trying. For me, generally, it's not really a hard adaptation. I consider myself a bit of an introvert, so it's not really a struggle to stay home for me personally. So just basically doing more of a lot of documentaries. Even right now, actually, I was checking out a documentary here on the sinking of the Concordia. So Concordia is a cruise ship that sank in 2012, and they were sort of comparing it with the sinking of the Titanic because it sank exactly 100 years after the Titanic sank. Mm. So a lot of those documentaries, that's what I'm doing a lot of right now, because for me it kind of serves two purposes. I get information and learn a lot. Mm-hmm. I'm a big enthusiast of history. I like a lot of history, what happened in the past and all that, World War One, World War Two, Gaddafi, all those. I've watched so many of them. But also secondly, it helps me hone and learn new skills in my craft, because some of the way these documentaries are filmed, voiced, recorded, edited is a learning experience doing majority of the time. Secondly, a lot of webinars, like the ones we're doing saizi, kila kitu siku hizi naenda online. I happen to run a podcast with
I was coming
of
there,
my friends.
Yeah.
So, oh, you are? Ah, okay, yeah. So, so we do a podcast with two of my colleagues. We used to meet once every week to record. Often times we would get our guests. But right now, because of the issues of social distancing and the fears and all that, we have now taken the podcast online. So we usually do what we know as every Monday evening from 8 p.m. We do an Instagram live with our guests. So people just tune in, ask questions and all that. So the world, we are now, I was even telling my friends, if this coronavirus had happened like in the 1940s, ama 50s, wakati ya, akukuanga na internet, akukuwa na vitu, unini. I don't know, we would have to get you a suicide.
How can you survive without
very
internet?
High.
Oh my goodness. Hello?
God for this. So yeah, a lot of learning and a lot of documentaries at the moment.
Yeah. One thing, Tim, I really find interesting, I always see, like, is it your profile picture, something you've like this CNN thing up on Bele? So of course I know you know Anderson Cooper. So I was watching an interview by Anderson Cooper.
I do know Anderson.
From that interview I watched, Alisema is an introvert, and I've heard you say again. So I wondered at that time, and I'm wondering again right now. Kusema wewe, you're an introvert. Unatembeanga huko tunakuona area code unapiga unaongea na watu huko. Hey, jameni.
I've gotten that question a lot. I think the best category to put it would be I am an introvert extrovert. So basically this means I enjoy my own space better than I do with other people. But it doesn't mean that if I'm in front of people or I'm in a crowded place, I sulk. I know how to blend in. So Nico, like up a borderline between an introvert and an extrovert, but leaning more towards the introvert side. Yeah, so I don't know. I didn't know. Anderson Cooper also said he was. I haven't watched that interview. I didn't know he's also an introvert. But basically, I enjoy my free time more than I do with other people. But it doesn't mean that I'm cold or I'm antisocial when it comes to it. I interact freely with people. After all, our job requires you be somebody who can interact with people. Otherwise, nobody will be willing to talk to you. It's a balance, but tilting carefully towards introvert. If you ask me to choose between doing an outdoor activity or going out to a restaurant and eating, or staying home and watching a movie or reading a book, I'd probably say I'd want to stay home and read a book or watch a series or something. So yeah, we go to Apple too.
All right. Now I want us to jump into something kidogo. Now we've seen you for some few years around up on our telly, and then you've documented a few you've documented some of the most amazing stories zimekuja from to our living rooms, and we've watched them. The other one with the street kids, I watched Area Code Tunafuatanga. So I mean, I want you to paint a picture. I want you to paint a picture because, of course, I told you the target audience for this discussion would be young people. So I want you to just paint a picture because right now we're just in a Twanga microwave generation. They think things happen like whoop, unajua. But I want you to paint for me a picture of how you built yourself, unajua, pole pole, just in your career right now.
So basically, I work for the Standard Group under its two brands, KTN and KTN News, which are two out of the four stations that we run, the others being Farmers TV and Burudani TV, known as BTV. But I got to the Standard Group after doing my campus education, which should be, I finished in December 2014. So I joined the Standard Group in January of 2015. So it's my fifth year. Damn, I'm old. And I haven't done much anyway. So 5 years. Wow, okay. I came in heat. But anyway, yeah, so I got to the Standard Group in January of 2015 as a volunteer. Mm-hmm. So I was an intern the previous year in 2014, during my third year of studies. So I did my 3-month internship, and after I was done, I was able to ask the editors if I could be able to come back as a volunteer once my studies were completed, to which they agreed. So in January of 2015, I went back as a volunteer, and I did it for about 7 months. 7 months, January, February, March, April, May.
Just volunteering?
August. For free. I'll pay you fare, I'll pay you anything. Like, they don't
Mombasa
give you
Road.
Anything.
Where?
So I was surviving mostly on my savings and a little bit of help from my friends, my relatives, my mom, sana sana. And so we did that for almost 7 months. And it's not easy. People usually think, mtu anaingia TV na kesho you're on air doing a story. It's not. So I did that for 7 months. The saving grace for myself as well as 5 others, because we got a job with 5 other people at the same time, is the fact that immediately when now we were almost giving up to mechoka, yani unasema, is this ever, will there be a breakthrough? Is when the idea to launch KTN News began.
Wow.
So the timing was just right. The timing was just right, because here was now KTN News coming on board. It was launched in August, in July of 2015. And because the vision of the station was to be a 24-hour news channel, they therefore needed people to work around the clock. And at the time, a majority of the people who are working hardest were the interns, kina sisi, because unajaribu proof point, like Naeza. Naeza ikitu maze. So for that reason, when the launch was there, we were able to negotiate something. That was myself. There's a colleague of mine known as Elvis Kosgei, who's now our reporter based in
Eldoret.
In Eldoret. We were with Elvis. We were with this sports guy is called Robinson Okenye. He's a sports reporter / anchor. And then with the 3 others who left, one was going to the business desk, the other was on the features desk, and the final one, I think, was in the general news. So they are not with us anymore, but we were with them at one point in time. So that's how we were able to get our first contract, which was 1 year. And we worked for that 1 year. Then the next year, I think in August, which should now be 2016, we got an extension of the second time. And then now when the elections were drawing close, about now 2017, is now where we were finally confirmed as legitimate guys. But the journey has not been easy, and especially if you're straight from campus. For me, the biggest challenge was the aspect of believability. And, you know, you have to win the trust of the audience.
Exactly.
The trust of the editors first, because if you don't first win the trust of the editor, then the editor will not even give you any assignment for you to prove yourself to the audience. So that was the biggest test, and I don't know how I can say it. It's just kujituma. Lazima tu ujitume kabisa. It's not easy. I remember like the first time back in 2014 when I was an intern. And you know, the internship is 3 months. It's a 3-month internship. So the first story I ever voiced that went on air for television came 2.5 months after I began my internship. So what that basically means is I did my first voice over story 2 weeks before the end of my internship. 2 weeks before the end.
2 weeks,
so you can imagine. And I remember so when it's a story that went on the lunchtime news. It was on the lunchtime news at 1 p.m. I remember every detail. I remember who I interviewed, who the camera person was, who edited for me, what time it went. So unaona, at that time, there was a bit of a concern. Like, now, this is now the time when you nimepata chance ya kwenda a story on air, but it just remained two weeks to the end of my internship. But lucky enough, the story I did was good enough to warrant the trust of my editors. Like, the editors were like, hey, who is this guy? How come I today I'm scared before?
Yeah.
So after that, I did, I think, two other stories. And then the internship ended. So in a month, in a period of 3 months, I only did three stories that went on air. And good enough, the three stories were convincing enough for my editors to see, okay, there is something in this.
There's something in this guy.
Yeah, so sometimes it's not really about the quantity, like, like you have to do a story every day.
Yeah,
if you see some of the most renowned journalists, kina Muhammad Ali, kina Jonah Lanamu, they were not people who every day they were in the news. Muhammad Ali would do one investigative piece in a year, or one investigative piece in 6 months, but still not lose his relevance. Even up to date, people know who Muhammad Ali
is. Yeah.
There are people and there are journalists who are on air literally every day.
Bana.
But you might not even know who they are.
True.
I learned a very important lesson that time, even when I was young, because unajua kuna ile ukiwa young, kuna ile unawashwa, like, why are they not giving me a chance? Why are they not giving me a chance? But
yeah, so I was saying, we'll only mention more, nikakumbuka kitu fulani. Unajua vile ukikuwa mtu kwa campus, for a course kama yetu, it is very engaging, maze, kuna pale MUFM, kuna ziyo KTS, as in, unajua there's that kind of, ile kujituma you talked about, unajua, like, every time you're aggressive hapa na pale, ukiona kamera hapo, you're fascinated, unafika pale, ile tu kirere, ile kirere mzuri, unajua ile positive, eh? So I was talking some time back na Musakali, of course, you know Musakali Juma. Afu alikuwa ananiambia, like, you see all these guys, mazaki na Elvis, akina Timo, akina Ase, wote tu, akina Raburu, there are people, they were aggressive in a way, as in, unajua, walikuwa tu hapa na pale, they were moving from place to place, they were always, like, on the move, kujaribu kuona vile wanazajijenga, because at the end of the day, ukishamaliza campus, at least you'd have experience setting you after kumaliza campus, unaweza pata experience yako from second year pia, ukianza kuhandle hizi mavitu and trying. Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
So that was the same case for you.
Yes, it was, and I agree with what he has said. Basically, use what you have, use the resources you have, where you have them, and where you are at that particular moment. So basically, people complain at employers want 3 years experience. Na sisi ndio tumegraduate tu juzi. That 3 years experience, you get it immediately, you walk into that school. When I joined Moi University, after I had secured my, and this is, I'm not saying this as a joke, it's very serious. When I joined Moi, immediately I had secured my room, and I had given,
come up again.
Kwaheris to my wazazi. And I was telling them that I will work at the journalism club. And I remember there was a guy, Isaac Koome, if I'm not wrong. Isaac Koome, last I checked, is working at Citizen TV Digital. But at that time, he was the secretary general of the journalism club, the Third Eye publication. So I just went to him at the student center, because normally during admission, you have been at Moi, you know.
Yeah.
There are these desks. Everybody puts a desk about their club, kuna Red Cross, kuna nini, ISEC, and all those. So I just went to the journalism club. I told them what I want, because I knew. But from the time I was even being called to Moi University, I knew it's journalism that I wanted to do. So I wanted to make sure I find those things that will make me as equipped as possible, so that after the 4 years, I can compete with my peers at KU, at UON, at Daystar, at wherever. So I registered for the journalism club on day one. I wrote very, very many articles for that club. And like I told you, I was an introvert. Siju kwa nini watu wanakuanga shocked. Because not very many people knew me. And Niko Fadai. Very many people came to know of me later on, like when I was in fourth year, Uko towards the end. But I was a member. I used to write articles. People like Malim Salat can tell you. There was a lady known as Alila Msenya. There were so many people who, I think even Nani, Dikembe Disembe knows, because I think he was a year or two ahead of me.
Okay.
So I wrote those articles, and I think around by second year, third year, I was able to join the Mo University radio, MUFM. So they say to akukwanga na KTS. So KTS hadn't started by that time. KTS started when I was leaving. So I never got a chance to work at KTS. But I got a chance to work with the Press Club as well as the MUFM. And even MUFM, I remember that Anitwanga nani womse yana approve voicing za watu. That guy didn't like me at all. It took me almost a semester and a half for me to get a show. I can't remember the name, but that's what I'm saying. If you don't know yourself, if you don't know yourself, you will easily be discouraged. And I remember day one, the first show I didn't do it alone. We were three of us. Mm-hmm. So it's sort of like I co-hosted the show. The show wasn't mine. Mm-hmm. The show was for a classmate of mine. So it was a Thursday show. It was Thursday every morning. It was every morning from 9 to 11 on Thursdays. Mm-hmm. Now your Thursdays, 9 to 11, tulikuanga na daro ya dafu by the QS, which I used to skip.
QS, except what TV.
Which I used to skip. But anyway, so once I was through with my studies, I was able to get a copy of a substantive number of articles that I'd written, mm-hmm. and then a few of the episodes that I had done at MUFM, mm-hmm. and I put them on my flash disk. And I did had copies of my articles with the third eye. Mm-hmm. So when I was now going now for an interview for a job, these are the things I took with me for me to get confirmed. So that unawambia, my name is Timothy Otieno, I'd want to be a journalist. But even at this point, this is what I've been doing to try and facilitate myself to be a journalist. So for anybody, in any career, not even journalism specifically, even if you want to be a banker, you want to be a doctor, you want to do stuff, like say, if you want to be a doctor, look for those documentaries. There are so many documentaries on medicine and all that. If you want to be an IT person, there are so many documentaries on artificial intelligence and how the world works. And try and get a friend, somebody who is in that. Someone met me way back in Kiwabado 3rd year in school. So I got, and because of the age of social media, it's so easy, squeezy. It's just a click of a button. Sajina mtu Victor Rono, una click na unamtumia DM. So akikubali sawa, sipokubali, you move on to the next person. So just always be aggressive. And just perhaps a lesson, a side note for that, when I was looking for a mentor, because I deliberately went out to look for a mentor. When I was looking for a mentor, Alex Chamwada was not on the top of my list. Top three, top five of the people who used to look up to. So the people who I used to look up to, and I remember I approached all of them on Twitter. Nikiwa tadia, nikawa DM, niliwa DM. I was very diligent, by the way. Nilikuwa naanza, oh, my name is Timothy Otieno. I'm a third year student at Poe University, Eldoret. I want to be a journalist. Just want your advice on what I can do to be a good. So all those people wenye nilitumia like five or six. Wote walinikulisha blue tick. Hakuna hata mtu alijibu. Not even one.
What?
Nobody. Na wengine hata kwa profile yao ya Instagram walikuwa they are mentors. In fact, there was one lady who I remember, I will not mention the name.
Don't mention.
Profile yake alikuwa ameandika ama media personality and mentor. So nikakulishwa blue tick. So one time I was scrolling just through social media, then I saw a post ya Alex Chamada. I don't know if amefanya story gani, I can't remember. I don't know if it was daring abroad or something. So vile nikamwona nikasema, let me just try this Chamada because he's renowned. I've seen him, I've known him for a while. So nikamtumia tu DM. The same. Nika copy paste trail and kuandikia
wale. Hey, my name is
inbox nikatuma. Luckily, he was able to respond. Oh, by the way, I'm also an Amoy. I'm an Amoy University alumni, and in fact, next week I'll be having a talk with the students of School of IS. Those days, my school was Human Resource. IS na Human Resource hazikuanga pamoja. So you know that.
Yeah.
We used to be separate. So kumbe IS students, the media class in IS had invited Chamwada for a talk. So akaniambia when I'll be around, we can hook up. We talk nini. So I went for that talk. Immediately we exchanged contacts. Akani mentor all the, he used to advise me, and aniambia, you know what? Keep those articles. You will need them. One at his own even advised me to burn my episodes on a flash disk and carry it with me. So basically what I'm trying to, the point I'm trying to bring across here is Alex Chamada was not the initial person who I thought would be my mentor, but he ended up playing an instrumental role in my upbringing in the media. So for anybody, regardless of any field, when you're going out, please make sure, look for a mentor, actively look for a mentor. And even if the people you approach don't, because God always has a way of finding somebody who will give you a listening ear. 100 people will tell you no, but you only need one yes for your breakthrough. No. So you just need one person out of 100 people to believe in you, and that's more than enough. So that's the advice I would give anybody listening.
Yeah, because again, one thing that is very interesting, Quakers here to Jimo, is you see, I mean, each time we, for example, we see you pale umenda juu Dagoretti, juu Dandora, Dandora, juu Wazungwa Kitambo pale. Then you just bring that story pale kwa teli. You know, it is very easy mtu kusama, okay, even naivi, but you know, there's what really goes into kutengenezo story yote. And that is what I think is just about life. Because even how you've narrated, I mean, from high school, ukukua pale composition, then ukafika pale campus, you are aggressive, you are DMing all these guys on Akulenga, but you are soldiering on Maze. So, you know, like the way you're just saying that in this discussion, like you're just putting that in like very few minutes. But pale kabisa, unajua mwenyewe, it took like really bidii, like you really had to push and push and kuinyima vitu zingine bana, which every young person should embrace.
Bidini lazima. It's a must. It's a must that you work hard in any field. Like, not even me. Let's look at people like Jeff Koinange. We just look at Jeff with all the glamour and the glitz and the poise and the decorum and the pronunciation and the articulation. But if you were to get a chance to sit down with that guy, akwambie ameanza aje, I'm telling you, people have stories and a half.
True.
Stories and a half.
True.
Even mine, I'm just scratching the surface because of the aspect of time. But the essence is, it really needs you to, one, you have to have passion for it. Now, the problem is people sometimes want to go into the media because
kwa TV, literally.
Famous and all that. It doesn't work that way. And sooner or later, people always, your true colors will be discovered. I really love Kenyan audiences, Kenyan television audiences. For one reason, Kenyan audiences can know whether you're telling them crap, and they can know whether you are a legit person. These major audiences that are times kama times kina Catherine Kasavuli.
Yeah, way back.
It's just an audience that just receive information, but would not be able to dissect, probe, scan, this is good, this is bad.
These are
the era za Moi, where ukiwasha TV, bendera anthem inachezwa for 2 minutes, and then the whole bulletin is about what Moi did from the time he woke up to the time he went to bed. But now, the audiences that we have right now, and especially Kenyan television audience, is a very, for lack of a better word, woke. They are very woke.
Yeah, woke.
It's a very alert, it's a very intelligent audience. And within a few minutes or so, they can tell whether you are a legit journalism, you know your stuff, you're credible, or whether we're tuning to you are shallow. And that's what I like about this audience. So, with time, people always tell us, and a good journalist is one, and secondly is one who reads widely and vastly. So you have to know your stuff. Ukiona nimeenda Dandora kwenda kufanya area code of the history of that place and how it started and where it got its name from and all that. I wasn't there when Dandora started. No, I wasn't born. Probably even my grandparents weren't born. But you have to go and engage in serious, serious research. Because my mantra always as a journalist in Rwanda, done by Timothy Otieno, I want that person to get value for their time. Because where we live right now, we have so many channels. We have so many stations. We have so many programs. So for somebody to say, at the end of the day, I want to sit down and I want to watch Area Code. And probably that time, they would have been doing any other thing. They would have been watching a series, watching a movie, watching an another channel, watching another documentary or anything.
Yeah.
So for them to say, I want to sit down and watch Area Code, as a journalist, it is my responsibility to make sure I give them the best possible product
value
to be, to warrant them spending time to watch me for 30 minutes or 20 minutes or even 2 minutes. Mm-hmm. And that's the mentality that I carry with me as a journalist. Even any day I walk out, even if tomorrow I'm assigned something, go to parliament, the president is doing this, that's the thing that rings to my head. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, when somebody sits down and watches this report, what value am I adding to them? Because these days, by the end of the day, by 9 p.m., ukienda kukachini, probably the whole country already knows by a large extent the occurrences of the day, largely because of social media.
These days,
tunajua. Hata before usiku ifike, utajua there are how many new coronavirus cases in the country. Kama sahi naona, we have now reached 607 cases. So by the time mtu anakachini usiku at 9, you're not telling them anything new that we have now 607 coronavirus cases. So that's where a good journalist steps in. Dissect this information. What does 607 cases mean for my viewer? Where are these new cases being reported? Why is it so prevalent? No, and this is something that social media can't give you. Social media will only give you the fact, the information, and then followed by memes and comments and criticism and praise. But to dissect it for the audience, that's now the true work of a good journalist. Dissect it, ndio mamangu mwenye anaiona from in Kondele or in Alego, wherever, and understand, okay, so these things are community transferred. So if not for this lockdown in the Katupikio, no, no. So aside from that, it's just a lot of hard work. But then also, I think that people forget, and especially for TV journalists, it's about teamwork. Ndio unione hapo nafanya Area Code ya Dandora, there's a camera person involved, there's a driver involved, there's a producer involved, there's an editor. And these people are usually not seen and they're not recognized by the viewer at home. So all the praise and all the accolades and all the criticism is always lumped on the reporter.
No. Mwenyana
kwa
kamera.
Sometimes it calls for, eh, mwenyana onekana kwa kamera. But you know, you have done productions, I've watched some of your production. You know, it takes a lot of time to travel, talk to people, secure lockdown interviews. So sometimes these people are the silent
unsung heroes.
Them as a journalist, the better they'll even be motivated to work for you. Unaona? So sometimes ukiwa mpoa kwa mtu anajitolea. Unaona? So it would not be good for me to go out on an assignment with a cameraman mwenye hatuelewani. I'm a cameraman who feels like I'm a snob. I'm a miniko na maringo. Unaona? So sometimes easy to the basics. It all goes down to the basics. How do you treat your fellow person? How do you treat that watchman you pass at the entrance? How do you treat that conductor you give your money? Because a majority of the time, these are the people who give us news stories.
True, yeah.
No, na wosu oja mwenye unasalimio kingia kwa building, na kombe, hey, by the way, Timo, una mama anapigwango, anabwana ake kwa nyumba. There's a battery case, ama there's a coronavirus case in my neighborhood. No, na, so there are news sources. So normally, I don't like dismissing anybody. I give anybody and everybody a listening ear.
For all these 5 years you've been in the industry, what is that one thing you can say you've learned?
What have I learned?
Unaweza summarize tu useme umelearn nini, like for these 5 years you've been in the media industry, unajua vile vitu kuenena mbio mbio, what have you learned so far? In summary.
I've learned to be dynamic. I've learned a lot of things, but I'll try to summarize.
Condense.
Number one is actually condense. I've learned to be dynamic. Okay, people say it, but be unique. Be unique. And that's for one main reason. Right now, when I began in 2015, there were not as many television stations as we have right now because of the issue of digital migration. So because you could have West FM, Fish FM, Hebrew, everything. They're all channels, and there are journalists literally everywhere. So how then do you make yourself stand out from the crowd? No, no. How do you make yourself distinct from the rest? And that's where learning how to be dynamic comes into play. So for example, like for a show like Area Code, Area Code was just a show that came out of nowhere, basically. I used to, I used to sit down and think, because I was born and I was raised in Langata Estate in Nairobi. So there was just a day I was just having an internal monologue. Nikijiuliza, na hii Langata Estate ilianza aje? Who gave it the name Langata? Why Langata? Why not any other name? How did Langata look like in the 50s and in the 60s and all that? Unaona? And then later on, that idea came, but about a month later, I saw it became more profound, like, mbona hii place ni Kiambu, mbona hii place ni Denderu. And then I sat down and said, I've never seen anybody in television try and get this information. So I just went, spoke to my editors, we sat down, conceptualized something, and then Area Code was born. And perhaps one of the reasons why people know Area Code so much is because it is something different. It's something that in Kenya's television history has not been done before. Unaona, it's not been done before. Most of the things that stand out are the things that haven't been done. If you see something like Daring Abroad by Alex Chamwada, what makes Daring Abroad is the fact that no journalist has ever go out of Kenya and do stories of Kenyans doing something interesting abroad. Unaona? The same way to Jeff Koinange or Larry on the Trend, nobody until that time had done what they were doing. So it's the biggest lesson I've learned is always try to be dynamic. The second lesson I've learned as a journalist is treat everybody with kindness, treat everybody as human beings, because these are your sources, these are the people who will give you tips on new sources, these are the people who will warn you, wanakuambia pale usiende, pale unaweza dungwa kisu, ama go this side, you know, ama MP is doing this and this and this and this. So I learned about your just being dynamic, be unique, try and do your stories differently. No, try and do your stories differently. Like for me recently, over the last 1 year, I've purposefully intended and trained myself to do stories of minority groups, because I felt we were doing a lot of BBI. Personally, I'm not really a big fan of politics. I can do it, but it's not, they're not those stories that make my blood boil. Mimi stories za mwananchi wa kawaida, that's where I love it. So about after mambo ya handshake ilianza, and then when BBI was becoming so often, I just decided, you know what, I'll try and be different. I'll not sing the BBI tune as a journalist. I'll try and go out and do stories about minorities, people whose voices have not been heard. And as a result of that, I was able to do a report known as Access Denied that talks about the challenges of people who live with disabilities in the slums. I did a story about wazees, known as the forgotten generation. People who are wazee, wanateswa, wapati doyao ya gava. I did another story about, I did a series on the deaf people and sign language and how we can help them learn. So such stories are what make me happy, see politics. So always try, the biggest lesson I've learned, try and be different from the pack. Treat everybody as human beings, and then nothing comes easy. Always work hard and better your craft. Always better your craft. Like right now, I'm telling you, vile niko 7 days niko home, these documentaries that I'm watching are things sooner or later I will try and implement in my reports on television. Then somebody will now say, hey, and Timothy is a good journalist. You're not born a good journalist. You become a good journalist. And this is by deliberately doing things to better your craft. And irregardless of the field, it can be business, it can be in medicine, it can be in law, always try better your craft. And especially now that we have free time, hakuna excuse. Unless labda una internet.
Hey, kuna balloons bana.
Excuse me, kuna balloons. Balloons za uhuru.
5G.
Zina float. 5G na float, my friend. Ni maana imefika mpaka Nandi.
Ai, Nandi hapa. Mimi sijaona Rosafi. Mimi I can confirm. Mimi sijaona internet hapa. Na tuki yangu. Wow. So.
Haina shida. But that's the, yeah.
Hey, quite insightful. Well, just as for somebody like you, umezoea kuuliza watu maswali. Rarely do you get asked questions kama leo.
I know, it's so weird.
Well, sasa, I think we're coming to the tail end, eh? Lakini, hello?
No problem.
You can hear
yes,
me
I
now.
Yes, I can hear you.
I'm saying tunafika tamati. I know bit of Swahili bana. Tunafika tamati visasa.
Hey. Sawa kiongozi, sawa kiongozi.
Chairman bwana.
Chairman.
Yeah, so I think kitu tu nataka useme tu ya mwisho eh. Yeah, maze tu uongeleshe tu vijana unajua because na out here unajua like unasemanga a society inafai patie homage ama inaitwanga aje pride of place to the young people au ndo wako na energy wako na ile satua na ile uwezo ya kuweza kusukuma ili taifa mbele. So just speak to a young person out there because of course au ndo watu wako kwa hizi digital spaces pale video kishatokea pale hivi kidogo just cheer up them as they waambie kitu hapa na pale because yeah, you've made some strides and of course you inspire several outside here. So just give them some insights maze tukimalizia.
My advice will be tied to what is going on in the world right now. The coronavirus pandemic that is in a cost to a lot of jobs. we've seen so many job losses. We've seen so many salary reductions. Companies are basically sending guys on forced leave and paid leave. Job cuts and all that. So for a young person, my encouragement would be, this time, yenye kuna hii mambo ya coronavirus pandemic, and we do hope it comes to an end very soon. Use this time to hone your craft. Because, wacha tu niwaibi, hii ni siri by the way, wacha niwaibi. After this is done, guys have lost jobs, others might even lose jobs coming into the future. But companies will be looking to hire people who have skill, but mainly on minimum wage. The people of my parents' age are wale watu wenye wamefika a point in the industry where they cannot get a salary below a certain amount based on experience and all that. And for any young person, mazi, I'd encourage them to take advantage now. Learn. Unaona hizo ma UN, mini World Bank, it will take between now and maybe December or so for things to normalize, hopefully soon. But beginning next year, companies will be looking to go back to where they were. Operations will be back to normal. And because they'll have laid off so many of their people who are most likely earning a lot of money, they will look for young people, but those who have the best skill and those who have the passion for the job. So right now, as a young person, hone your craft, kabisa. If you like artistry, in your time, unanunua canvas, paint, rarua, paint ingine, unaona, like, hone your craft. If you are somebody who wants to be in the radio, start a podcast now. Do podcasts, send it to your friends, share that link. If somebody wants to write for the newspaper, open a blog. Unaona, write, whether to criticize, zingine will improve. So that by the time next year in Africa, you are a ripe person. Yani umeiva kabisa.
Umeiva.
You cannot be denied anymore. So my encourage would be, you time you wanna complain, oh, corona, I'm just stuck at home, nini. Use this time to build your craft, to hone your craft, to make those connections. Build your CV now. Build that CV now.
Larry said, Alisema, you really can get along. You really can get away with a lot of confidence. Not a confidence.
Yes. Confidence is very important. He was very bold and confident.
He was even telling Jeff, you see, anambia ati wewe hata una kitu kingine special, but you see the way you just say like, oh my, this is Jeff. Unasema tu na confidence. I know wasa anapenda. Simple.
Hata kama una kitu ya kusema after hiyo.
Bora uko confident, my friend. Hata Larry said akikuwa trainee reporter huko alikuwa na interview CEOs who had 30 years of experience, but alikuwa anaongea tu very confident hapo, like he knew what he was talking about, na people walimwamini.
Exactly.
Being roju.
That's very, very true. Mm. Ni vizuri kwa roju. Lazima ujiamini kabisa.
When, what is the worst that can happen?
That's the encouragement of that. Hey. There's nothing that, the worst can, that can happen is no. Like, let me just give you a small story then I saw, let you.
Okay.
When I was completing my internship, you were 3 months. The one now for 2014, so that I go back to my final year in campus here for PR. On the second last day of my internship, I met one lady. She's called Edith Kimani.
Now
when I'd gone to Mombasa Road, and now she's in the DW. I've never even told her this story. So that time, it was the second last day, it was on a Thursday, my internship was ending on a Friday. And at that point, I'd done the three stories in 3 months, like I told you. And I was very worried. This is not enough. I feel like I've wasted my time. I should have done more stories. Like the editors won't believe in me and all that. So luckily, the first story that I ever did that went on air during the lunchtime bulletin, niyeye ndiye alikuwa amesoma hiyo story. No, no, but she had never met me face to face. So alikuwa ameniambia, "When do nilisoma story yako juzi nini nini sometime?" Nikamwambia, "Yeah, that's me." "Ah, yeah, I didn't know you're such a small body with such a big big voice." Nikamwambia, "Yeah, it's me, it's me." So then she asked me, "So what's up? So what are you planning?" Nikamwambia, "Ah, in fact, tomorrow is my last day of the internship. So I'm going back to school for my fourth year." Akanambia, "Really? You mean you're going back? You mean you've been here that long?" I was like, "Yes, yes, I've been here that long." Then she asked me, because we were driving, alikuwa ananipatia lift to Tau from Mombasa Road. So akaniuliza, "So what do you want?" Mimi nikamwambia, "Honestly, I just want, okay, at this point I can't do anything because I have to complete my studies. So I'll just go back to school, but I would have really wanted to come back and volunteer with you guys as a volunteer reporter." Then akaniuliza, "And so have you spoken to the editors about that?" Those days nilikuwa naogopa, by the way. A lesson in being bold. So nikamwambia, "Hey, you know, our boss at that time was the great Joseph Ageo. Joe Ageo was our managing editor that time. So nilikuwa nimemuogopa. Hey, unajua tu ukiwa intern. I was really fearful that time." So nikamwambia, "Mimi naogopa. I don't think I can be able to go and talk to him about my my intention to come back and volunteer. I'll just take this chance. Nimeshukuru umenipatia 3 months. I'll walk away with whatever skills I learned." Akaniambia, no. "You do this. Eh? Tomorrow on your final day, go to Joe Gale's office. Knock on the door. Introduce yourself, sit down, and tell him, 'My name is Timothy Otieno. I've been here for 3 months. I've done this, 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 but I'd like to come back as a volunteer during my holidays.'" Then nikamwambia, "Hey, hapana." Akaniambia, "No, akaniambia vile umeniambia saa hizi, what's the worst that could happen?" Aliniambia, "The worst he can do is say, 'No, thank you. Thank you for your time. No.' Then you'll go to school knowing, okay, at least I tried, but akakata. As opposed to you just going back and then in future, ufanye journalism, then you start regretting. What if I had gone to Joseph?
Ningejaribu.
What if ningejaribu? Unaona? So vile aliniambia hiyo kitu, it really pricked my heart. Eh? I went home thinking about it. Nikasema, okay, she has a point. Let me just try. Akikata, sawa, ndarudi shule kama at least nijaribu. Akikubali, the better. So the next day I just went, knocked on his door. Sat down in the middle of introducing myself. Akanambia, "You're Timothy Otieno, sit down." I didn't know at that point, I didn't know he knew me, because none of my stories had gone for the 9 p.m. bulletin. Because naendanga saa saba. If you're an intern, stories are because naendanga 1 p.m. up. Then before upewe, sasa the slots za usiku za mabig week. So nikamwambia, okay, akanambia, "Oh, I know who you are. I saw your story the other day. It was a very good story. So why are you here?" Nikamweleza tu, nikamwambia, "My internship is ending, but my intention is that I be coming back and volunteer. I don't even want to be paid. Let me just volunteer and give you guys stories. And I'll go back and I don't think there's a problem in that. So you just go when your holiday is about to end, or when it ends, just come back to Nairobi and come see akanirifa kwa deputy wake, who is now our boss, our current boss. You just come see the deputy ME. She will guide you around." So when I made a point so that when I was coming, by the time nilikuwa na our first holiday, because that was in May of 2014. It ended in July. So nilirudi shule August hadi December. So by the time we were coming back for our holiday in December, I already had 4 story ideas that I wanted to execute. Because in the back of my mind, I was like, I don't just want to come back and kujetu nikae kwa newsroom ati niko. I want to give these guys value. I want them to see the value in me. So by the time I was coming back, I had 4 feature stories, which I all executed. The next year, hivyo hadi nikapata job. So that's the lesson I'm trying to bring a point here is what Edith Kimani instilled in me that day, which I've never even told her, was you two being bold, the aspect of just being bold and saying what's in your heart. Wakisema no, sawa, other than walking away with regrets. What if, maybe I should have just, no. So it's a good lesson for everybody. And I believe the fact that I went back to Joe's office the next day to say I want to come back as a volunteer is the reason why I'm still here. Unaona, the reason why I still work for this company is the reason why I still have jumpers here written KTN News, as you can see.
Yeah, so we can.
Boldness goes a long way.
It
goes a long way. And it works.
Roju, kujiamini.
That's the encouragement. Jiamini. Jiamini na ujiamini ukiwa na confidence na uwe na substance.
Nukweli.
Sijiamini tu nauna anything to show for you.
Nukweli maze.
Jiamini so that ukipewa chance ati Victor now do for us a live link. Unaongea mpaka watu wanasema, yeah,
hey, amekuwa wapi?
It's not, eh, hey, where has this guy been? Unaona?
Nah, yeah, yeah.
Exactly.
Wow, Timo maze, thank you so much bana. We!
No problem, man. Tumongea
kama 1 hour.
Eh, wacha tu. Unajua journalist kazi ya kuongea ikwangi shida.
Eh, tunaweza payuka hadi jioni huko mana.
Tunaweza payuka hadi jioni, hadi kamera izimwe.
Bana, batu ishe.
There's no problem.
All right, man, maze, nimeshukuru sana. Thank you so much.
It's a good initiative. Keep doing it. I don't know that you've done it with other people. I'd also encourage when I join into a media. So these are good.
I have.
Yeah, that's it's really nice. It's encouraging. I encourage you to keep doing it. Thank you also for having me. Nashukuru kabisa.
All right, maze. Stay safe, bana.
Yeah. Asante, you too.
Okay, cheers. Bye-bye. Thank you.